When it comes to monitoring availability, there are a few things that you might want to monitor, and there are a few places you can look. These are all the things you might consider monitoring: your region and data center availability, whether or not your server is available, if your database is online, what's the status of your backups and maybe the history of your long-term backups, your replica status, and even failover reasons. Now, like I said, there's a lot of things to monitor, but there's also a lot of tools that you can use.
Yeah, no, this is quite a few choices here. You know, you look at the middle of this thing, and this is what's familiar to everybody. You know, X events or catalog views or DMVs. What's different are things in the Azure infrastructure and also CLI type available tools for you. So a couple examples stand out to me. Like, you have to monitor your own data center today. Like, how do you do it for Azure? Well, we have a service health dashboard that's pretty cool to look at service health of Azure SQL itself across different regions across the world. You know, resource health is something that you can get access to the portal or even through REST APIs to look at possible problems that have occurred with your database, which could explain why your server database was not available. You mentioned about, you know, backups. Long-term backups can be looked at a historical perspective, both through CLIs and both on the portal. And then the activity log. You know, one thing we talked about in the Azure ecosystem was this activity log concept behind the scenes from Resource Manager. That's pretty cool because that's going to show you things like restore operations. You know, you talked about and showed earlier, when you restore a database, you create a new one. So anytime you create a new database in Azure SQL, the activity log can record how long did it take, who did it, you know, and when did that happen. I love the example you showed earlier in one of our videos about replica statuses. So you have the ability through unique DMVs for Azure to look at the status of, say, even a business critical replica scenario, or even a case where you showed like geo-replication. And just remember that powering all of this is REST. So the REST APIs are kind of the core foundation, like a lot of things in Azure, and a lot of stuff you see in here from the portal and through CLIs and PowerShell are all built on REST APIs, which could be used at a very low level to monitor anything you see here in Azure. So we showed you the kind of things you want to monitor, which are like in you monitor in SQL Server today, or things like your data center. We talked about all the range of tools, whether things in the Azure portal, T-SQL, or CLIs. We think we have all the tools you need to monitor availability of your Azure SQL database deployments. We'll see you in the next video.